नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स वन एंड ऑल. टुडे लेट मी टॉक अबाउट द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल इन वेरियस डोमेन्स अक्रॉस all the major industries, specifically from the IT field, art and cultural field, and business units. Let's talk first about the IT field. I remember the same kind of unemployment kind of thing which has had happened, and I have gone through that phase maybe in the period of 2007 or 2008. It was the worst hit. It was the worst recession that one could ever think about. Prior to that, it was way back around 2004 or 2005. There was double recession, triple recession, which really damaged whole of the employment opportunities as such. This is in the IT. Coming to the business units, number of businesses as per the census, out of my experience in looking at it, between 1999 to 2017, small scale industries, MSMEs, small business units, manufacturing concerns, textile industries, these industries were between 1999 to 2007 were approximately maybe like 10,000 plus. The moment recession started, supply and demand, the supply got the demand, or the demand for the product started getting reduced. They didn't have money to buy. Individuals never had any money to buy. Our economic system was not so very good during that period of time as well. And worst part was supply was more. When I say supply was more, the products were overflowing in the blockyards. I was not introduced to art and culture form till the period of 2010 or 2011. From the period of 2010 to 2021, 20 today, 10 years period. Number of aspirants who are into art and culture what happened was the way that they took this form as a secondary medium and learned it as a freelancer and they were doing it as a time pass. When I say time pass, it's like hobby or for the sake of keeping yourself uplifted. This is one point. I am talking between 2010. In 2010, between 2010 and 2015, this was the trend. Between 2015 and 2020, in the 5 years period, the individuals shifted their gear to the teaching profession of the art and culture, be it any classical dance form, Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, Mohiniyattam. Number of institutions that got raised, or it was like mushrooms at every street between 2015 to 2020. And number of doctorates during the period of 2010 to 2020, if I really look at it, spiked up. Whereas before 2010, between 1998, that is when I finished my degree. I finished my degree in March 1997. Between 1998 to 2007 maybe, 2007 or 2008, number of doctorates awarded were as low as 4,000. The same thing between 2015 to 2020, number of doctorates numbers spiked up to 8,000. And number of dance teachers, number of teachers got spiked up. This is pertaining to art and culture. Now, this was one mode of employability during the period of 1990 to 2007. Employability was totally different structure. It was more or less based on the tuitions or other things. There was no freelancing concept during that period of time. There was no freelance teaching of classical dance form during that period of time. There was no coaching, there were no coaching centers also, so many. I remember only 3 or 4, I can count on fingers. Today I have coaching centers like mushrooms. And the kind of system or the kind of scheme in the education, be it from the curriculum point of view, be it from art and culture point of view, really annoys me. Between 1990 to 2007, the quality of teaching methodologies, research methodologies, schemes and structures, the quality of students that were produced, it was awesome. They had that versatility. And what was the highest percentage? Highest percentage was touching only 90 or 92. If he or she was touching around centum, that means he was outstanding. He or she was outstanding. There were very few. Let's come to 2015 to 2020. Number of students or the individuals or number of teachers, number of students or number of individuals getting centum. If I take with the ratio, it is 50:100. If 100 students are here, 50 of them or 60 of them get symptoms. And when he or she attends this, the interviews or whatever it is, they fail. I'm telling you practically because I have worked with a multinational company. I have seen rejections. Why they reject? On what reasons? On what basis the employability happens? Now, coming to the point of educational institutions who are trying to teach the students or who are into matriculation, 10th, inter and all. Between 1990 to 2007, number of people coming out were around, I'm giving you the base figure, approximate figure. 10,000. I'm giving the base figure. I'm not going with the realistic figures. If I go with the realistic figures, it will be more. Let's take 10,000. The same thing between 2010 to 2020, if I see, the numbers spiked up to 1 lakh. That is 90,000 plus. This is the approximate figure I am giving you. Be it from normal graduation, inter, PU and all. The very important point now, coming to the point of art and culture, vocational courses and other extracurricular courses. The numbers spiked up. Everybody started looking at art and culture, vocational courses. Everybody started looking at the other part as a part of employability, wherein he or she could get that money. The point is, these numbers too spiked up. When I say spiked up, they got stacked up with what you call numbers way, way beyond the expectation. when I say way, way beyond, it is 5 times what the numbers were between 1990 to 2010. Now, where do you really think we as individuals failed during this pandemic attack? Forget about running source, running money, or people not having money, or whatever it is. Forget about that. But what are the aspects that really mattered, or what are the aspects that have had influenced the declination of all of these, and people suffering with not having money? And today, from every corner, people are running short of cash. First thing, lack of quality. Second thing, not doing it correct. And the third thing, what is it that he or she has learned? Has he or she learned in a proper way? Today, number of PhD holders who are holding doctorates, if I ask them, they will not be able to answer. And the fifth point, getting a doctorate, I agree, at the age of 22, at the age of 22, getting a doctorate, how do you really think? One can question. I'm questioning the university that gave doctorate to 22-year-old. And number of doctorates who are holding between 22 and 30, between 22 and 25, are in thousands. Between 2015 to 2020. Specifically, I am talking in the field of fine arts and culture, dance and music, classical dance. And the quality that they give doesn't reach up to a level. This is one part of it. When it comes to teaching, what are the social skills, social ethical skills, political ethos skills, survival skills that are being taught in the school? How many teachers come out of BED, BEd or TED? And how many of them are guiding properly? Today, if they would have guided students properly, today we would not have seen so many discussions and so many things and so many things, so many requests coming out. With so many pitfalls happening, there are only three industries, to my understanding, that survive. Four, in fact. One is IT industry, other is art and cultural industry, other is business, self-employment, and the fourth one which is what is vocational course, and teaching field. These five have not been taken care in a proper way. And that is one reason why we are not able to get Sarvepalli Radhakrishna sir Jr., Kalam sir Jr., or M.S. Subbalakshmi. Or Vempati Chinna Satyam Master Garu, Master Garu Junior, Vedantam Satyanarayan Sharma Garu Junior, in classical dance form. Where exactly the problem is lying? Forget about employment or forget about the employability. If we are giving, if institutions or colleges or the universities, whoever are producing individuals on a yearly basis, does not have the quality, kind of quality that is required, how do you expect everyone to really come to the mark and, you know, sustain themselves? Where does the sustenance equilibrium state happens? And on top of it, parents pressurizing on the same, not thinking about it. This I have suffered a lot, which I could not tell to my parents. In case if I wanted to explain also to my parents or anyone for that matter, they had, he is doing it, he is getting it. For how many years it will happen? It's high time we need to start thinking about how we can really look at the education system's development. Forget about the bank balance. For this, what is it that is needed? We need to have a dedicated teacher. That kind of teacher who can teach the good quality of education. When I say good quality of education, from all of the fields, specifically, it is not from the percentage basis. It has to be based on the survival techniques. How exactly he or she can manage. Are we having those kinds of teachers? For your information, during my 9th class or during my inter, or even what you call before March 1997, when I finished my BCom, I was not able to speak a respectable English like this. But you know what? I should be thankful to my teacher who had taught me the systematic and the schematic way of understanding things. He was such a dedicated teacher. To this day, I remember him. His name is Pitambar Das sir, by the way. He always used to beat me in class because I used to fail in English. Do we have those kinds of teachers who can teach exactly what is required and what is the quality? Forget about beating or everything, anything. That's a different aspect. That was his style. But whatever that he wanted to teach in a systematic way and schematic way. And same thing goes with one more teacher who had gone with the psychology aspect of the student. and then went to teach. How many of the parents, how many of the individuals, how many of the people think this way? None of us think about this way. This is what I have been trying to explain. This is what was I have been suffering from. I was searching for a very good teacher in dance form, in classical dance form. I need to share this. I wanted to learn the dance form. When I asked him the question, why we are doing this step? This was in place which I do not want to take the name of it, but you know what the dancer's answer was? We were taught this way. Why are you questioning me? If you want to learn, just learn whatever that I am telling. That is not the way, friends, one and all. If you are learning something, try to learn in and out of it. Only then you can survive during this period of time, pandemic time. The one who learns with the shortcuts will really suffer to the core. He will not be able to answer on anything. Today, to this day, if I am doing around 187 videos or 188 videos till date, I wanted to know in and out of it. And only then I will do, else I will not do. So like this, dedicated teachers, how many of them are there? From fine arts and culture, from schools, colleges and institutions, vocational institutions. And various other institutions wherein he or she can survive. To give you a classic example, one Mr. Nag from Odisha, he is a third class, mere third class, but he is absolute beautiful in writing poetry and he got President Awardee. And he is a very simpleton. Haldar Nag. And there I had gone through one of the profile in LinkedIn or Facebook. Who was a school dropout, intermediate dropout, with a percentage of 40 or 45%. And today he is holding the knowledge of the highest level, and he is holding 3 doctorates. Though he passed his degree and all, that's a different aspect how he did. But when I spoke to him, he shared his experience. He was telling, this is the quality of education system today. And that is a reason why the individuals in the fine arts and culture are suffering today. They are not able to survive. Teachers also. Why they are being pulled out? why they are being shut out, why they are being ignored, not ignored, but they are told, please go, we do not have money. Have we ever understood? There are three factors involving that. First is, what is the quality of output that you are giving? How you are thinking out of box? When I say out of box, that doesn't mean you doing genius work. But what is it that you are thinking out of yourself, and what is it that you are giving out of your own? And the third is, are you trying to use your natural intelligence, or are you trying to copy the other's ideas? This is applicable for every field, ladies and gentlemen, and one and all. How many of us really have this? To cite you an example, when I went to a university showing my works, which I did on my own, and this also I am doing it on my own, whatever research that I am doing in music and dance, I am doing it on my own. They asked me, what is the qualification that you are holding? I wouldn't want to name that university, but the person who interviewed me didn't even know what exactly the base level study of the subject is all about. This was in the field of dance and music. The base level study of dance as to why the dance came into existence and shastras came into existence. When I explained him, he said, it was a thrash that I am speaking. This is the quality of education that we are having today in the field of fine arts and culture. We are not teaching the right kind of thing. How many of us agree to this? And a direct question, it's an open-ended question to individuals, parents, and everyone. On what basis do you calculate your kid's ability or whatever it is, intelligence? Is it based on the percentage? If it is on the percentage, let's say like he is getting centum, is he or she able to think naturally? If he or she is able to think naturally, he will not get a centum, believe me. Life is not so easy, friends, one and all. It has to be understood in depth. Let's be very clear on this. Then ask for whatever that we are suffering today. Governance, corporate governance, governance not having money to pay or whatever it is, that's a secondary aspect. But primarily, are we doing justice to this? To this is an open-ended question to institutions, universities, colleges, parents, and everyone. And this is a direct question to even my parents. If today you are telling I am wrong, of course, that came through your understanding, but that's fine. But let's be honest on this. How many of us really think this way? Thus, I conclude this video with a note on these pitfalls. The day we cover this, all of the issues will fall in place. If not, this will continue for few more years. This will continue for centuries and centuries and centuries. I am not being rude, I am not being harsh on anyone, but the hard-hitting facts. Thus I conclude this video. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with you. Have a nice day.